The anterior horn of the lateral ventricle extends anterior and into the frontal lobe. So this is the foramen of Monroe, and the anterior horn is extending anteriorly into the frontal lobe. So the anterior horn is extension of the lateral ventricle anterior to the foramen of Monroe. So the frontal lobe is lodging the anterior horn. So it is with body of the ventricle at the intraventricular foramen. The anterior horn has got the roof, floor, and the medial wall. Again, the same almost sides which were of the body. So the sides or walls of the anterior horn are continuous with the body. So the roof is again the undersurface of the body of the corpus callosum, so which is continuous anteriorly. So the corpus callosum continues anteriorly to cover the roof of the anterior horn, limited anteriorly by genu. Now, if we go through the diagram, so this is the corpus callosum which is covering the top of the body of the lateral ventricle. That corpus callosum continues anteriorly as well, and then it turns over here to form the genu, the corpus callosum, and by such a way, so it limits the anterior horn anteriorly by making the genu. So the genu of the corpus callosum is the anterior limit of the anterior horn, and it continues lower down as the rostrum. So the rostrum lies below the anterior horn, and genu lies anteriorly to the anterior horn, and it continues at the corpus callosum, the remaining part which forms the roof of the anterior horn. So the anterior horn roof is formed by the corpus callosum, which continues anteriorly to limit the anterior horn as a genu. So these are the two structures which we should understand. So we are coming again onto the lateral section. So this is how this is the genu which is limiting the anterior horn onto the opposite side of the septum pellucidum. So on the other side of the septum pellucidum is the anterior horn of the right ventricle. So this is going to limit the anterior horn of the right ventricle anteriorly. And this is also the rostrum which is going below. So the floor will be formed by the rostrum of the anterior horn. The genu will limit it anteriorly, and the remaining part of body of the corpus callosum will form the roof of the anterior horn, which continues as a roof of the body of the lateral ventricle. Now the floor of the anterior horn of the lateral ventricle is by the round head of the caudate nucleus. This is the anterior horn. Now you can see the anterior horn. It is the slit-like, and it has got the roof which is formed by the corpus callosum. It has got the medial wall which is continuous over here, and this is the floor which is or the lateral wall which is continuous over here. So the floor is by the rounded head of the caudate nucleus. So this is the caudate nucleus, head of the caudate nucleus, which is going to form the floor of the anterior horn of the lateral ventricle. The medial wall is formed by the septum pellucidum and the anterior column of the pharynx, which is continuous. So this is the anterior column of the pharynx, and the septum pellucidum will be in the middle. So this will be going to form the medial wall. So we have discussed the medial wall of the anterior horn. We have discussed the floor, which is found mainly by the head of the caudate nucleus, and the small portion of the rostrum, which we discussed, of the corpus callosum, that is also going to form the floor of the anterior horn. So the rostrum, which is going to form the floor of the anterior horn, and the caudate nucleus, these two structures, they are going to form the floor. The medial wall, septum pellucidum, and the anterior column of the pharynx, and the roof is formed by the body of the corpus callosum. So these are the three walls which are of the anterior horn.